Good morning. It is good to be with you here today. Just a few announcements. Welcome to our radio listeners and our online viewers. Today's online broadcast, Facebook Live and YouTube, sponsored by Harriet and Colin Barrett in memory of Myrtle Barrett. Thank you to our celebration ringers for special music today, and to all of the volunteers here who make this service happen, to all of our ushers and sound people and video people and everybody. Thank you so much. Let's see, our sympathies go out to family and friends of Dorothy Sather, whose funeral was held here this last Wednesday, and to Marilyn Johnson, mother of Linda Anderson. Funeral was held last Friday at Emmanuel Lutheran Church in Beersford. Our Education Task Force and Fellowship Committee are hosting an egg extravaganza on Saturday, April 3rd, beginning at 2 p.m. We're asking for donations of individually wrapped candy that be brought to the church office by March 26th. First Communion class is happening next Sunday, a week from today, after the second service. We've been reaching out to the families of fifth graders, and if you haven't gotten that that communication yet, then, or maybe we just missed your fifth grader family, then let us know, and that class will be after the late service next Sunday. Camp registrations are due tomorrow, so you can get your camp registration to your fifth grader or thereabout aged person, to Jenny. And we're also doing family camp this year. This will be the 17th summer that my wife Amy and I have been going to Outlaw Ranch in the Black Hills. And you all are welcome to join us. And we'd love to have you come. So if you'd like information on family camp, come and talk to me or call the church office and they'll connect you with me. All right, let's see here. I think that is about it. The third coloring project is up and ready. I think this might be my favorite stained glass window that we have. It's kind of in the corner and no one ever really sees it. It's way over there. I can't even see it from here. So if you have someone who likes to color, you can find these in the church office as you come in the door. Three different of our stained glass windows to share with your little ones, or even if you like to color. I like to color. So those are in the church office. All right. I think those are all of our announcements, except the announcement that I, of course, left my bulletin in the front pew, which means I'll be right back.
Glass window. It is a wonderful depiction of a story of the Bible. It is a triptych, meaning there are three windows, and in the one in the center, Jesus is scattering seed. Take some time after service and look at it in color before you color.
That was such great high use of technology. I love it. All right. Well, please stand in body or spirit. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, keeper of the covenant, the source of steadfast love, our rock and our redeemer.
Amen.
God hears us when we cry and draws us close in Jesus Christ. Let us return to the one who is full of compassion. Fountain of living water, pour out your mercy over us. Our sin is heavy, and we long to be free. Rebuild what we have ruined, and mend what we have torn. Wash us in your cleansing flood. Make us alive in the Spirit to follow in the way of Jesus. As healers and restorers of the world, you so love. Amen. Beloved, God's word never fails. The promise rests on grace. By the saving love of Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God, your sins are forgiven, and God remembers them no more. Journey in the way of Jesus. Our service continues with the singing of our opening hymn, 113 from Praise and Worship, Open Our Eyes, Lord.
Feast of celebration, all of creation sings for joy. To the God of life and love and freedom, praise and glory forevermore. Now is the feast of the Lamb once slain, whose blood joy to the God of life and love and freedom, praise and glory forevermore. Power and riches, wisdom and strength, and honor and glory to Christ forever. Now the feast of celebration, all of creation sings for joy to the God of life and love and freedom, praise and glory forevermore. For God has come to dwell with us, to make us people of God, to make all things new. Now the feast of celebration, all of creation sings for joy to the God of life and love and freedom, praise and glory forevermore. Let
us pray. O God, with steadfast love you draw us to yourself, and in mercy you receive our prayers. Strengthen us to bring forth the fruits of the Spirit, that through life and death we may live in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
First reading today is from Jeremiah 31. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt. A covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, said the Lord, I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord, for I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more. We read responsively from Psalm 51. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love. In your great compassion, blot out my offenses.
Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness and cleanse me from my sin.
For I know my offenses, and my sin is ever before me.
Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. So you are justified when you speak, and right in your judgment.
Indeed, I was born steeped in wickedness, a sinner from my mother's womb.
Indeed, you delight in truth deep within me, and would have me know wisdom deep within.
Remove my sins with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be purer than snow.
Let me hear joy and gladness, that the body you have broken may rejoice.
Hide your face from my sins and blot out all my wickedness.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Cast me not away from your presence and take not your Holy Spirit from me.
Restore to me the joy of your salvation and sustain me with your bountiful spirit.
The next reading is from John 12. Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, Sir, we wish to see Jesus. Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven. I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again. The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, an angel has spoken to him. Jesus answered, this voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself. He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. This ends the reading.
Please remain seated. Beautiful. Thank you very, very much. Next week is Palm Sunday, the Sunday in which we think about Jesus' triumphant entry into Jerusalem and then the beginning of Holy Week and all of the things that then unfold in the services of Maundy Thursday and Good Friday, and then bringing us to Easter. But that means that We are getting closer and closer, if you will, in our readings now to Jerusalem. We're getting closer and closer to Jerusalem in our Lenten journey together with one another. And as such, the texts that are assigned through the lectionary for these weeks make us a little more and more uncomfortable. These are not necessarily the passages that I like to preach on. The assigned texts for these Sundays are ones that we don't usually tend to gravitate towards for our own reading. Most of us don't find these to be the comforting scripture passages that we want read at our funerals. In fact, if we pay attention to them, they might even begin to cause us to squirm a little bit in our seats or to shift our attention elsewhere, to maybe pay extra attention to that stained glass window Pastor Joel was talking about, or think about what in the world am I going to make for dinner today? Because we too know somewhere in here that the closer and closer Jesus gets to Jerusalem, the closer and closer he gets to his death. The closer and closer Jesus gets to Jerusalem, the closer and closer you and I get to dying to ourselves. For the same fate that awaits Jesus in Jerusalem awaits us. It awaits you. Following Jesus means dying to ourselves, to our wants, to our wishes, and to actually hearing and paying attention to what Jesus calls us to do and to be about. We hear again the first half of this gospel reading. Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. Jesus is coming to Jerusalem to celebrate Passover with all of the other pilgrims who are coming, and people are coming from different backgrounds and ethnicities, and they must have heard who Jesus is and want to know a little bit more about him, and so they're trying to get a little closer to him and see what this is all about. So they came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, kind of a connection, hey, can you hook us up? We're similar. And they said to him, sir, we wish to see Jesus. Philip went and told Andrew, and then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. And Jesus said to them, the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it. Those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me. And where I am, there my servant will be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now, again, why might I have said that these passages that are getting us closer and closer to Easter are not the ones we gravitate towards and are not the ones that bring us comfort and are not the ones that we want our family to read at our funerals? It's because they compel us to not live a comfortable life. Think about that. They don't call us to live that comfortable life. These are not what is referred to as the prosperity gospel, which just says, hey, follow Jesus and everything's going to be okay. That's what we really want to hear, though, right? I know I do. We like to come to church and to feel comforted. We like to feel that this crazy life we're living somehow makes sense. But if we really pay attention to the Bible and to what's in it, and if we really want to be Christians, sometimes this crazy life doesn't make sense. We want to hear that everything happens for a reason, and that if we just trust, everything's going to be okay. But sometimes it doesn't. Things don't always happen for a reason. We live in a world that experiences the brokenness of sin, and sometimes bad things happen to good people. And that is not God's will. What is God's will is that we, that you and I, are then called to be about the emotional and sometimes physical work of living in a way that does bring the gospel, that does bring good news to people who are experiencing brokenness, to people who are hurting, to the places where life gets messy. Because when we do, that stuff spills over on us, and nobody wants that. And that's where it gets uncomfortable, but that is where we are called as Christians. Let's look more closely at what Jesus is saying to his disciples here in this reading for today. Now remember, in the Gospel of John, Jesus is fully aware of what is awaiting him in Jerusalem, and he's also fully aware of what his disciples will experience if they too follow him. Specifically, let's look again at verses 25 and 26. Those who love their life lose it. And those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there my servant will be also. These verses put a mandate on us if we are to be Christians. They say that to be Christian means going to the places to which Jesus went. So let's think about all the other Bible stories we know, all the other Bible passages that we have come across about Jesus. Where do we see Jesus? Where do we see Jesus? Jesus wasn't in the easy places. Think about where those places might be in your own life. Jesus wasn't in the fancy places. Jesus wasn't in the popular places. Jesus wasn't in the comfortable places. Jesus wasn't in the simple places. But Jesus was often in the messes. He was with the outcast and the dirty people. Will you go there? Jesus was often with people who were crying, people who were in deep grief. Will you go there? Jesus was often with people who were simply looking to belong, to fit in, to be reconnected, to be included, to know that they were loved and valued, even if they were of the wrong race, the wrong gender, the wrong social class, or if they held the wrong political views, or if they held the wrong interpretation of Scripture. Will we go there? These are not always fun places to be, but they are important. And if we want to be a Bible church, which so many people in this country say we want to be a Bible church, then that is exactly where Jesus sends us. This good news today says that these are the places to which we should go, that you are called to enter into the brokenness, to the grief, and to the pain of other people. Okay, now I don't want to leave you completely hopeless this morning. There is really something in these texts that does bring comfort to me and to you in these readings. And that is that if we all collectively follow them, then there will be people who will meet you in your brokenness. If we follow them, there will be people who will meet you in the mess of your life. There will be people who will meet you and listen with you and hold your hand and cry with you in your grief, who will be there for you when you need them. And that is a powerful promise to hold on to. But in the meantime, this Lent, especially as we have been reading lots of these letters from Paul through our Wednesday night studies and Tuesday online gatherings, if we read these letters that the Apostle Paul sends to the churches of his day, and then also, if you will, to us, we get sent to the world. And so I leave you with a paraphrase that the Apostle Paul so often says to the church. Suck it up, buttercup. Get out there and rejoice in your suffering for the gospel.
Please stand in body or spirit. God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Stay with me, remain here with me, watch and pray, watch and pray. Stay with me, remain here with me, watch and pray, watch and pray.
Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. You wash us through and through, and remember our sin no more. Make your church a community of forgiveness throughout the world. Give your people courage to forgive them, through them, show the world new possibilities. Bless ministries of repentance and reconciliation. You fill the earth, from tiny grains of wheat to the mighty thunder, with your presence, and you call us to attend to your will for all creation. Grant weather that prepares the soil for seeds. Protect all from violent storms, floodings, and wildfires. You promise to write your law on our hearts. Guide citizens throughout the world to shape communities that reflect your mercy, justice, and peace. And give them creativity to work for the welfare of all. You sustain us with your bountiful spirit. Restore the joy of all who need to know your presence. Those who are lonely and feel unforgivable, those who need healing of mind or body, those who are dying, and all who grieve. Jesus calls us to follow him in life and death. Empower this congregation in discipleship. Equip children and teachers in Sunday school, confirmation and learning ministries. Give us your truth and wisdom, and teach us to follow Jesus. We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Please take a moment and share a sign of peace to those around you. And you may be seated for our offertory. Please stand as you are able. Faithful God, you walk beside us in desert places, and you meet us in our hunger with bread from heaven. Accompany us in this meal that we may pass over from death to life with Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. You call your people to cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that renewed in the gift of baptism, we may come to the fullness of your grace. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This is the new covenant shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us all to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. All is prepared and all baptized Christians are welcome to come forward for the Lord's Supper. There is a hand sanitizing station on each side aisle, and then come forward as the person ahead of you clears and moves forward in this process. There is gluten-free wafers, there is grape juice, and if you choose to come forward just for a blessing, leave your hands at your chest. If you would like to receive the bread, put your palm out. All is prepared. Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away. This food can death destroy, and you have freely granted the cup of endless joy. My Lord, I do not merit the favor you have shown, and all my soul
please stand in body and spirit. May this body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you always in his grace.
Amen. Now, Lord, you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people. A light to reveal you to the nations, and the glory of your people Israel.
God of steadfast love, at this table you gather your people into one body for the sake of the world. Send us in the power of your Spirit that our lives bear witness to the love that has made us new in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You are what God has made you to be, created in Christ Jesus for good works, chosen as holy and beloved, freed to serve your neighbor. God bless you, that you may be a blessing. In the name of the Holy and Life-Giving Trinity. Amen. Go in peace. Share the good news.
Okay, we will.
Thanks be to God.